Hi, this is Ms. Delosier, and this is a quick review over the differences between taxis and kinesis. So taxis, or plural is taxis, is a directional movement towards or away from a particular stimulus. And if we're moving towards a particular stimulus, we would say it's a positive taxis, and if we're moving away from a particular stimulus, we would say it's a negative taxis. And these stimulus, the stimuli can be anything. It can be a chemical stimulus, it can be light, it can be food, it can be magnetic, really anything. So chemical would be chemotaxis, light would be phototaxis, etc. A kinesis, or kinesis on the other hand, is random movement in response to a stimulus. And because it is random, it's non-directional movement. So let's look at an example. So let's have a stimulus here, and we'll have a gradient. So we're going to have high stimulus at one side of the gradient and low at the other. So basically, the closer you are to the stimulus, the more of the stimulus you're sensing. So in this case, a good example would be like a chemical stimulus. So an example of chemotaxis is in marine invertebrates. We've talked about how in marine invertebrates, the sperm and the egg need to meet in the water. So the egg will actually give off a chemical which actually attracts the sperm. It doesn't like really attract the sperm like a magnet, but the sperm actually will move towards the egg through chemotaxis. So here's my sperm, and you can see that it's going to just move directionally towards. So basically, it's going to move along the gradient. So it can sense as it moves, is that like more or less? So it's basically playing a game of like hotter, colder. So if there's more stimulus, then it's going to continue in that direction. If it was a negative taxis, then it would do the opposite, and it would go away from it. In kinesis, we would have the same object where ultimately we want to get there. And you can see underneath the D endoseria, I've drawn a little roly-poly there. So I've got my pill bug. And instead of moving directly towards that in a directional movement, what I'm going to have is I'm going to have random movement. And you've seen that when we did the animal behavior lab, that the behavior of the isopods is just kind of random movement until it gets to what it wants. And that stimulus can be anything. It doesn't have to be food. It doesn't have to be an egg. There's all sorts of different stimuli for the organisms. I hope that helps you clarify the difference between taxis and kinesis.